putting steam behind the piston for a quarter of a stroke. Spare about half a stroke and spare about three quarters. So it's not very efficient. But as you get going, you can get back to about 30%. Oh, that's £200 of steam on the steam brake.
That's why the pressure there.
So all that's telling me is the brake is hard on under the floor. Because otherwise, if that goes to the fire, I might ignore it and think the brake's come off completely. This brake sometimes sticks on this plunger.
So, do you have to clear the...
Clear the what?
The cylinders.
Yeah, because you can hear it exhausting. You can hear
it. Just clear it out.
Yeah, effectively doing that clears it. So I don't know if he's going to give us the road or not.
Well, he gave the shed road earlier. I think they're working on the signal.
Oh, okay.
So I'm not sure whether he's just waiting for him to finish working on the signal.
Okay, fair enough. So that fetch controls gear, then that's the regulator. So
that's like being in first gear in a car.
It's sort of about. You'd normally start with the train, you'd normally start away about there.
Right.
With about 300 tons on. And then, but with a light engine, we'll probably be able to start at about 40%. Then right. As you get going, you can wind it in, but you have to do it based on, you base it on your speed, the sound, how the train's accelerating. So there's a multitude of different things you use to work out when you're going to do. But engine like this is nice sometimes, but if you're shunting, it's a pain. They're easier with a big pole because you can very quickly reverse the engine.
What I don't understand is you've got a boiler full of steam.
Yep.
And you're adding water.
Yep. Yep.
So why doesn't that condense the water?
It's a good question. So the water is heated by the steam as it goes up the injector pipe.
Right.
When it goes up into the clack, inside the clack you've got trays. So the water doesn't drop straight onto the water.
Right.
It's on a tray.
Oh, go green.
Got green.
Go
it's
green.
On a tray. So what happens is the water will heat up a bit more, but it hits the actual.
So it's not going in cold. It's already been heated by the injector.
The injector makes it hot anyway, because you're putting steam through the injector and it mixes with the cold water. But you need cold water for it to mix properly, because you're asking it to condense so that it goes through.
Drop the pressure.
Sorry?
Yeah, it will do.
Oh, it's
drop
the pressure, yeah.
I put the feed on there. You'll see.
They're very loud.
Very loud.
Just so you know, okay? They're a bit loud.
If you want to press it down, it's time to drop. Alright? Power. Sorry. If you're looking to run down to about 160 quite easily, you still have enough power to send it in. It looks so great. So yes, you are getting power. If you've got enough coal on the fire, you can feed, and if the driver's got the regulator open, you'll feed and you won't lose any pressure, because the fire is sufficiently hot enough. I mean, that fire's not hot. You're looking there, that's not hot, that's quite dead.
Because you've got pulling it.
Yeah, but if that fire was white hot, you could put water into the boiler and it would not lose pressure. In fact, sometimes coming up burning to bank, you put water in and it still makes pressure. Sorry, I got a red, sorry.
Yeah.
So, you see it's starting to recover now, it will recover quite quickly. But you are putting reasonably hot water in, but not hot enough for it to cause any problems.
Go on, you can do it.
Yeah, no hands.
Thing about driving steam engines or steam trains rather is that you use the gradients to help you. So on a train, before we get to the top of the bank, we'll actually shut off. So the back of the train will actually act as a bit of a brake.
Green for two.
Before we start actually going down. Yeah, green for two. And similarly going up, you know, if you want to slow up towards the signal that's uphill, just shut off and roll. And again, the train will just naturally
from the weight,
that train there, originally they weren't that successful, because they put